Here's something I want you to do every week, not at the end of the week, not at the beginning of the week. They both have their own issues, but in the middle of the week, I want you to back away from your charts and get yourself refamiliarized with the big picture. That is, go to your weekly chart. Don't start drilling down into your 2-day and your 4-hour. Just look at your weekly chart and get a feel for what's happened over time and where you are now. Too often, we get sucked into the minutiae of little moves and we forget what's really going on in the overall market, whether it's the S&P 500, whether it's the NASDAQ 100, whether it's bonds or gold. Those are the four that we chart for you every day, but those of you who are charting other things, who are looking at stocks, looking at sector funds, looking at other commodities, maybe you're looking at silver or palladium, whatever it might be, corn futures, whatever it is you're interested in, back off and get an overall feel for what's going on. As we look at, say, S&P 500, we can look back in time and see how far it's come up, where it's blown off steam, where it ran up, where it blew off steam last time, and how high it's gotten lately or how low, depending on where you are in time. But again, run it up to the present time and just get a feel for where you actually are. Are you starting to see red candles rolling over, things still green and flying up? Are you starting to stagnate out and get flat? So again, just get a feel for what's going on. Look at your price percent oscillator. That's your big, big indicator that shows you where things really are. And look at price. Look at your Bollinger Bands. How far are they stretched out? Farther they're stretched out, the more volatility. The tighter they are, the less volatility. Look at your derivative oscillator. Get a feel for the entire movement and where you are in time. Don't get so stuck on all the little charts that you forget what's really going on overall. Same thing when you look at the Qs and you see where that's going. Same thing when you look at bonds and where things are sliding sideways and not sorting out. Again, backing off a little bit in time can give you a better perspective as to where things have come from and where they may be going to. When you see double headers, you see different things happening. Maybe you see divergences, you see things getting higher on your price percent oscillator than they did in the past at the same time. All sorts of stuff that can lead you to various conclusions, help straighten you out, get your head straight so you're not so focused on the little things, you're missing the big. Because remember, the big money is in the big charts. I'm going to say that again. The big money is in the big charts. When we start looking at gold rolling over, going up as it did back in October, somewhere around the 113, 114 mark, and then bumping up as high as 127, 21 by February, that's some major movement. And then, of course, topping out at 127, 21. And where has it bottomed out recently as I record this? At 119.55. So again, those kinds of things are important for you to pay attention to also. And you can see how accurate your charts are, your bigger charts. And of course, our gold chart on the weekly is prescient. Who the hell would want to buy gold when you see it crossing over, going down? You might want to sell it before that happens. You can buy it back a hell of a lot cheaper later. So again, pay attention to these charts. On Wednesdays, just mark your calendar to step back and look at the big chart and get a feel for what's going on. God bless, my friends. All the best from the whole team here at Charting Wealth World Headquarters. You want to support what we do? Of course, buy our book. You can see a link in the show notes to do that. We'll send you an autographed copy. And also, be a Patreon supporter. We've got lots of good training at the website, chartingwealth.com. Go there and subscribe. Be a daily review receiver. We will email it to you for free. The daily review, 4 days a week. The weekly market review, once a week. And of course, all the specialized training as it comes out. Patreon supporters get even more depending on your level. You get a free book. You also can receive actually free Traders Journals. In addition to everyone receives the short chart training, the S&P quarterly chart training, the Bitcoin training, all sorts of great stuff for you there. And the monthly question and answer session, a live telephone call-in that we have, along with our reviews of the stocks and ETFs you're interested in. God bless, my friends. All the best again from the whole team here at Charting Wealth World Headquarters.